I'm Slim Show. We are back. We're back with Stephen Buda, comedian Stephen Buda.
Hi.
How you do? Oh, is this mic on, Slim?
It's on. My fat stomach can't get me close enough to say hi. I'm all in. My left nut's hanging out of my pants, but I'm here.
Slabo, tuck it in for him.
All He's right, like, all right, the cat's coming up to play with him.
I'm like a fat fuck. He like ran here. I'm like, dude, I haven't run since seventh grade. Are you out of your fucking mind right now? What do I look like over here? What's going on, boys?
What's going on, dude?
How are you?
We're all right.
All right.
Nice.
Doing our show.
Are there a lot of trannies in this town? I'm only going by the name.
I don't know who these guys do.
There's quite a few. I actually personally know.
I mean,
two.
I don't know if you want your fans to know that you, where you broadcast
tuck
out
it
of.
In.
Tuck it in. Tuck it in. That's how Staten Island says it. Yeah, hey, I went out to tuck it in.
Fuck it in.
I know of two trannies. I think Slambo knows of like, what, 15?
No, just one.
That's not enough. Get us up on the show if you guys know so many trannies. Come on, get us the lady boys.
Ain't nothing worse than going down there to grab a vagina and you grab a tree trunk. Kadoosh, you know what I'm saying? I don't like the cream-filled kind.
Yeah, I'm not big over the cream-filled
kind. There's nothing worse than you go down there thinking you're going to have fun and something pokes you in the eye. Kadoosh! It's never personally happened to me, but I'm just saying. I'm guessing.
It happens. How long have you been doing comedy for, Steven?
Call me Buda, by the way, because like,
Buda, my bad.
Every time you say Steven.
Steven.
My mom, like you. I feel like I should be folding laundry right now.
Steven.
People don't even know Buda is my last name. They're like, that's a great stage name. Where did you come up with it?
You're
like,
genius.
I fell out of a vagina and they gave it to me. What do you mean? I had no choice in the matter. Everyone's like, it's such a great name. It's like, really? Have a cholesterol level of a 90-year-old in second grade, right? And be 500 pounds with the last name Buda. See how much fun you have.
So you got a lot of shit in school?
Oh, my God. Yeah, I had to fight my way. I had to fight people all the time. I fought my sister once because of that shit, but no. But, yeah, no, it sucks, bro. 17 years I've been doing comedy.
Nice.
17. Not that I'm counting. But, you know.
Facebook has to remind you.
I hate that shit.
The memories.
The memories.
Yeah.
My favorite part of the day is when you come on and Facebook, he's like, just so you know, here's some assholes whose birthday it is. I hope you give a shit.
I like the anniversary of your friends. It shows you. Or it shows you like a clip. Was
they
it?
Put
like
that
a,
stupid like record player.
The
fucking
book. The album. The album.
Yeah.
Oh,
the
you've been friends for this many years with this person.
The special friends.
I love when it's a comedy club you haven't worked in a while. You know what I mean? Here's a place that doesn't book you. Maybe you want to share some pictures of the times you should have had together.
All the money you lost. All the gigs. Think about that. 5 years ago.
I can't wait to the day that I could just like tell these places, fuck yourself! I'm aggravated, I would say, all the time. Probably.
Yeah.
Probably.
That's good.
It's a good thing.
It is good.
Being married twice, you know, you get the twitches.
I never went for the second.
No, don't.
Only married once, bro. No.
My girlfriend now, she knows. She knows. You want to get married? As soon as she's like, why don't we get married? In the well you go. You're going in a fucking well. There's three of them there already. Yeah, comedy, 17 years.
Yeah.
I started Rascals. You guys remember the old Rascals days?
Yeah.
Bob Nelson was like the first time, the first like experienced live comedy I've ever seen. Like, because we've all seen, you know, George Carlin and Eddie Murphy and all that, but to experience comedy live, like, you know, to go all, it's just like off the cuff stuff, you know? That's, I don't do much of that, but I love the guys that do that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
Like, Otto and George, my mentor. Oh, yeah.
I know you called us once, I think when Craig was on.
Did you?
And mentioned.
I smoked a lot in my life.
You mentioned Otto and George.
Yeah. Have you ever seen them? Or
I loved them. God. I saw them live a couple times. Once at the Opie and Anthony Traveling Virus. That was great.
Yeah.
At PNC Art Center.
I just love when he yells out at people.
Yeah. You know? This is the best.
Like someone will walk and stay out.
This is a nice place we're in. Roaches were putting paper down on the toilet.
Yeah, he would just like... He had the worst self-esteem I've ever seen in a comic. You wouldn't think that. But he yes. would get off stage and he would just be like, ugh.
I heard he beat himself up a lot. Yeah. Like,
and he had, you know, he has like, they have like multiple personality disorder, like with the puppet and everything. Like that's, they become too, because if you watch the Letterman, you ever see him when he did the Letterman special?
Yeah.
He crushed it, right?
Yes.
And then at the end, if you watch the end of the video, Letterman goes to shake Otto's hand and you hear the puppet go, ugh. Like, you're mental. You're a problem. Yeah. The most hysterical thing I've ever seen.
Like he projected all his negative thoughts about himself onto the puppet.
Yeah.
The puppet.
Yes. Yeah, the puppet.
The
would
puppet
just,
did all the
like, he would just cough,
the
and the puppet would go, kill yourself, Geppetto. You know? I have great footage of me, like, opening for him. And if I'm doing really, like, if I did really well, you could just hear him when I would walk. You could hear him talk because you still have the camera going, but they don't. And I got a standing ovation once and they were chanting Buda as I got off. And I walked up to him and you just hear him go, nice try. It was just great. But, yeah.
Wow. That's great. Who else have you worked with?
Tracy Morgan. That was a weird one. Yeah. That was like a... The whole time, this lady saw me do something somewhere, and, you know, you like how I have the exacts? I have no clue where she saw me.
Saw me do something.
We were in, she had a party in Red Bank. They had a lot of money, and it was for her husband, and I, you know, she wanted me to sing to him and act all gay with him, which, you know, I did all that.
Who wouldn't?
And, so the whole time... It's like, yeah, I don't know what time Tracy's going to show up. We'll see what happens. Tracy this. I'm thinking it's a... I thought it was a stripper. You know?
Yes.
Up until the point where they introduced him. It was Tracy Morgan. I'm like, what?
Wow. How do you not say Tracy Morgan?
Right. It's Tracy. Tracy's coming by.
Now, mind you, I just did a half hour of running around acting gay. I'm sweaty. I did a chicken impression. I am yelling. I did a turkey. I do all kinds of animal. I'm sweating my ass. I'm running around like a fucking lunatic. Like if I look like a Cherokee Indian trying to make it rain. You know what I'm saying? I'm running around. So he just gets up there and goes, damn, Buddha working hard up here, cluck-a-lucking and shit. I ain't working that hard for y'all. And I was just like, oh, my God. Just for him to mention me was like, and I was in awe. I got like one shitty picture with him because he was like out, you know.
He just did a set of
That's all he did.
Like, who hires Tracy Morgan for a party? Like, what are you kidding me?
Tracy Morgan money. Do you have it? Do you have that?
No, I don't got it.
I don't have Tracy Morgan money for my birthday. I can't even afford Craig Lloydgren. And he should pay me to show up. Craig Lloydner's great. He's fun size.
He's awesome.
I call him fun size comedy.
Fun size?
Yeah, you can take him wherever you need him.
Put him in a suitcase.
One of those little dogs just carry around.
Early on, I got a check still that I saved. Seinfeld paid me $50. Yeah, the second year in, I guess he thought I was a comic, but I wasn't. I was doing open mics, and we were at Rascals. And he paid everybody not to do the show that night because he wanted to perform for his friends and family. And he wrote, and he's like, you look like you're funny, you know, because, like, I was the only fat guy on the show. Because fat guys are all hysterical.
Did he pay you the most?
No. You were bigger? I wasn't the headliner. I do usually get paid by the pound there, Jerry.
And you said he paid everybody so they wouldn't
so they go wouldn't
on?
Go.
Yeah,
so
yeah. Because he felt bad, like, he's canceling the show. So he wanted to pay everyone.
Oh.
And I guess he thought I was like part of, you know, because I was on it. I was just a special guest for like 5 minutes.
Oh, okay.
But what did he know? He knew nothing.
Thank you, Jerry.
Thanks for the check. But I never cashed it. I saved it.
That's a keepsake.
That is cool.
That's definitely cool. Yeah.
And doing comedy 17 years, I really needed to cash that $50 check at least 37 times.
Do you have it like framed and everything? Or?
No, I have it. I have it in a box somewhere, like in a fireproof box somewhere.
Yeah, that's
like my
awesome.
Whole house are burned down.
Just need
and
that.
And they'll show up, and like there'll be no witnesses, nobody left. They'll be like, "Oh, Jerry Seinfeld must live here. We found one of his checks." Gilbert Gottfried, I worked with a lot.
Nice.
He's creepy, man.
Is he?
Really? Oh, my God, he's creepy.
Yeah, I heard he like played like right down the street at that Sea Oaks Golf, you know, the golf course down there. And they said he was kind of off that night. Like,
he's apparently creepy. Off every
just,
night.
I was just going to say, probably not just one night.
You know his persona, how loud he is. When you meet him, he's like, hello, how are you? Good to meet you. Oh, thank you. Go. Yes. Well, thank. Bless your heart. Thank you. And on stage, he's like, you know, talks about, you know, when the day those girls were rescued by the cops. Remember, they were this guy, the father, was holding these girls for like 3 years.
Yes,
and was constantly like raping them and had kids. And
yes,
he comes out and goes, he goes, so this father's raping these girls for 17 years. And he pauses and he goes, I can't even get my daughter to hold my hand when we cross the street.
Oh, wow.
And then in the back, he's like, hello. Hi, how are you?
How'd you like the set?
Like, he's got that split personality thing going, too. Like, yeah. It's this different guy when he's on stage.
He just does crazy shit on stage.
Two nuns are getting raped. One looks to the skies and says, forgive him, Father, he knows not what he's doing. The other nun says, this one does.
And then in the back, he's like, I'll have mozzarella sticks, if that's possible. Please. Sauce on the side, please. God bless, dear, your heart.
It's like, makes no sense. You know what I mean?
Where are you going with this, buddy?
This is spot on, though.
It's like diced, and then he does the wisp. You know what I'm like? So I'm banging this whore, right?
Then afterwards, I was like, thank you.
You know, like, it makes no sense. Charlie Murphy a couple of times.
He was good.
Rest his soul.
Yeah.
Bernie Mac, I met a couple of times. Nice. I have no clue what he said. Nobody knows.
Dude, hold on. You do comedy, say I got to work hard. You just have four more shadows to do. I'm going to stick with it, Cody. Or I open my honor breasts. You know why? I don't want no more kids.
I just, you just look at him and fucking blink.
Yeah.
And Charlie Murphy sounds just like Eddie Murphy. Hey, man, you a funny man. I like all that shit you were doing before. That shit was hilarious, man.
I saw him open for Burr, and he got the town wrong that it was in. And I couldn't tell if he did it on purpose or by accident, but it was still hilarious. It was so funny.
That's great.
So funny.
Yeah, I met Dice a couple times. I worked, see, when I started on, like, Jim Florentine, Jim Norton, Don Jameson, Bob Levy, these guys just started where I'm at now. So I'm hoping, you know, to not have their career. They're doing well now.
Yeah.
I met Artie Lang for the first time last year. I opened up for him.
Cool.
Yeah, that was odd. I'm on stage. I'm supposed to do 15. I had to do 45 because he was late.
Wow.
So that was
How
fun.
Do you do that? Like, did you just have it?
They're just going like
all ready
this.
To go.
I'm from stage. I'm like,
what
does this mean?
Are we making pizza? What does that mean?
Some taffy.
For you orderings out there, I don't know if it's on radio, but he was making like the stretch symbol.
Wow. Shit.
My pants do that before I put them on.
Shit!
But like, Rob was asking, did you have 45 minutes?
Like, that's what I mean.
Oh, yeah, I have an hour
and
a half.
You're just ready to go.
I have an hour and a half.
Cool.
I've done you know, comedy... Cove in Springfield, they let me do whatever. Then we book shows too. I'm part of a company, LaughterLoungeComedyClub.com. We book shit too. So if I'm headlining that, I'll do over an hour or whatever. But I mean, 17 years, you better have an hour. I mean,
yeah.
Some of these guys, it's like they're doing comedy since we started, and they're only still doing 15, 20 minutes. I'm like,
wow.
Maybe you should, you know, I don't know, drive a cab. Like I do still. I still do.
How's that?
Ugh. Brutal. You got to care where people are going, you know?
Oh, I'm so tired.
Really? I have four jobs. Go fuck yourself.
So tired.
I get this creepy lady in the car, bro. She's like, it's a 45-minute drive. The whole time. She's talking to me about Harry Potter like it's a moment in history. Now, I've seen a few of them. I don't know exactly what I'm watching.
The first
And she's talking about this owl that saved Harry Potter's life.
Oh, if I had an owl, I'd trim his nails, wash his feet.
I'm like, if this lady jerks this fucking owl off,
lick his beak.
I'm dropping her off. So she looks at me and she goes,
you know, if you had an owl and could ask it anything, what would you ask?
And she doesn't know I'm a comic. I'm like, I would look right in that owl's face and go, Mr. Owl, honestly, how many licks does it take to the Tootsie Roll Center? Because I don't know. That bitch shut up the whole time.
As she should have.
Had another lady tell me that she had gremlins in her vagina. The guy's got gremlins. I'm like, really? The car or the alien? She pushes me.
How am I going to get a car up there? You're all right with the alien, though, huh, Crackers?
I don't know. How do you get a car in your vagina? I don't know. Car wash rules.
A compact.
Antennas down, windows up.
Gremlins in her vagina.
So I drop her off right before she gets out the car because it's one of those automatic slide, you know, doors. I push the button, and just like when it's 28% left, I'm like,
don't feed them after midnight, you crazy bitch.
Actually, I hope she does, and they rip her apart from the inside.
You can't put water on them, right? Is that a
water, thing? Yeah. Light. Don't feed them after midnight.
Which makes no sense, because what if a female mugwai is banging a male one, right? Or you know what I'm saying? And the guy like doesn't want to, like he pulls out.
He
like
can't.
You can't. It don't matter if you pull out, you're still making more, right? That's good. Write that down.
Oh, that's great. You told me too, Stephen. Buda. Sorry, bro. That's a hard, hard thing.
I'm just going to grab your nuts every time you call me Stephen.
Well, then I'm going to say it a lot.
Stephen!
Buda, you said that you shouldn't be alive right now. You mentioned that in a message to me.
Oh, that's a crit. Well, I was married twice, mostly.
One of them should have murdered you, I guess.
Real quick, because that's like a 4-hour story.
Oh.
Yeah, what happened was... I fell out of a truck. I slipped on ice. Something froze inside the back of a box truck, right?
Yeah.
So, way to bring the show down, by the way.
Sorry.
No, I broke my back in two different spots. So,
wow.
During the recovery, I put on 200 pounds. I shot up to almost 500. And then I was on steroids because my back was just shot. And you know how guys are on steroids and they have the acne thing going?
Yeah.
So I had that apparently on the inside of my groin, had no clue. Went to sit down to play with my son, and you know how you fart but it doesn't come out?
Yeah.
That's what I heard, but I didn't fart. I had no clue what happened. Basically, I had like poison inside of my body.
Wow.
Growing, right? So imagine right above your pubic area. I got like a swollen thing that's like a tumor just filling, and I can't sit up. So I go to the hospital. New Year's Eve, they cut me open. I have gangrene. I have a flesh-eating disease, and I have a staph infection.
Whoa.
My balls swell up. You remember Johnny Dangerously?
Yes.
My balls blow up. My dick is caught inside, right? Now they have to catheterize me, but not normally. They have to go through the side of my penis. Yeah, through the side, exactly.
Yo.
Chinese people, they can't do this, too. So I'm on all kinds of crazy shit. Long story short, I had to go into an oxygen thing like Michael Jackson used to sleep in. Yeah, talk about a thriller. So I went in there for three times a day for 2 weeks, had to get all this stuff. I mean, basically, all the skin on my left nut was gone. Craziness.
Jesus Christ, man.
So I don't know how I lived through that, because they say you have a 33% chance of living for each one.
Yeah.
So is anyone good with math? What's 33% times 3 divided by death?
It's a lot. It's a
divided
lot.
By death. I think it's 666 is what the answer is.
I think so. Do you still have any complications from that?
No, I just...
Do you want them to, you dick?
I have like... You know how girls get trunk butt from anal? You know what I'm talking about?
Like a prolapse?
Yeah.
A little pink sock?
I have my balls are blown out, I guess. I need a tire rotation. So, yeah, I have that going.
Nice.
But then I had the gastric bypass a year and a half ago. I lost 195 pounds. But it sucks. When you're 500 pounds and you lose that much, you're still over 300. It's like,
kill yourself.
So that's where we're at now. I've had a lot of shit happen to me, and, you know, I'm still positive. Not HIV, but I'm positive.
I was
going to
ask.
I'm positive in life.
Hopefully not the HIV. You know? Little Birdie told me you're obsessed with Halloween. Mm-hmm. How far does that go?
I mean, here's what happened. I was, we're just jumping around, aren't we?
Yes.
I was a big Mike Tyson fan, and all his fights were on HBO. Well, my dad used to record them for me. Now, I grew up in the 80s. Kiddies don't know what on-demand is, and we didn't have the internet.
Nope.
And we didn't have CDs, DVDs. We had VHS. Well, my dad, the dumbass, set it on EP, which we'll record for 12 hours.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. That's a long one.
Now, how long is a Tyson fight? 7 minutes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I had 11 hours and 53 minutes of HBO in the middle of the night. You know what kind of crazy shit they show? Nightmare on Elm Street, Tales from the Crypt.
Yes.
Hello, kitties.
All kinds of... So that I was hooked. So I love horror.
Nice.
I love Halloween. I deck out my house. I scare kids. I mean, I have a well in front of my house that I throw ice, dry ice in.
Yeah.
I have this projector from Home Depot that projects onto a window, so it looks like zombies are inside.
Oh, that's awesome. Cool, man. That's awesome.
Yeah, I go all out, bro.
Nice.
I love Halloween. That's like.
It's my shit. It's one of
my house
favorites.
Is decorated for Halloween all the time.
That's what I was going to ask, if you leave all the decorations
all the time.
Up.
Yep.
I leave everything up.
Nice.
Yeah, Halloween was.
You dress up?
Yeah. I mean, I'm Jason. It's just the easiest. Yeah. Just a mask and some shitty fat guy clothes. And I never can catch anyone, no matter how fast they run.
That's all right, because you can just walk as Jason. Anyway,
yeah.
That's all he did.
Yeah.
So.
That's all he did. Like, how do you act like Jason? Like, you're out of breath and you're tired. All right, perfect. If I was a hockey player, that's what I would look like. That and Star Wars is pretty much my entire life. I live by the.
This guy knows a lot about Star Wars.
Yeah. Do you?
Yeah, I'm a
big
Star
fan.
Wars fan.
Too much. All right,
cool. I got a little question for you.
Okay.
I always ask a Star Wars fan. Okay. This is a thing I came up with. That nobody's ever asked this. So, you've seen all the movies.
Yep.
So this is proof that Lucas wrote all 9 scripts, and he picked the middle, right? So we have New Hope, Empire, and Return.
Yep.
So in Empire Strikes Back, when they're going to put Han Solo into the carbonite. You remember Chewbacca starts flipping out and he's tossing stormtroopers?
Yeah.
Boba Fett, he's in this scene, goes to shoot Chewbacca, but Darth Vader pushes his gun down.
Yeah.
Do you know why?
Shit.
Do you have some do-do-do-do?
We do, I think.
I don't have that.
That one.
You don't know? Think, come on. You've seen all... Now, remember, he wrote the script. In his, you know, he wrote the scripts or storylines or whatever.
Show me what you got. He goes and pushes the gun down.
Why does he give a shit who Boba Fett shoots? He wasn't going to shoot Han. Han was in the fucking thing.
Give us the answer, you prick.
Next time on Rob.
I'm thinking because, like, Leia was there and he somehow.
He doesn't know that's his girl. He
doesn't
know
it's
his daughter yet.
Disqualified. Yep.
You seem to be really frustrated right now. You think it's frustrating now? Try to eat yellow vagina with blue pubes. It's disgusting.
That was a good Homer Simpson. Oh, man.
I'll give you the answer. Because Chewbacca, he didn't want Chewbacca to get killed. That's your hint. Now, why wouldn't he want not Chewbacca to get shot?
Why wouldn't he not?
Because he liked his dick. He got that big, delicious Wookiee dick.
Mommy.
What a thing.
So who is Chewie carrying?
He's carrying the droid. He's carrying the
3PO.
Right.
So he built 3PO as a kid and did not want 3PO to get destroyed.
Jesus Christ.
You like that shit?
I love that. He realized that was his.
Thank you. Good night.
That's the shit.
So you're saying like George Lucas?
Nobody ever gets the answer when I answer.
No one has
ever gotten the answer.
Wow.
That makes sense.
Cool.
Yeah,
I came up with that on my own because
dollars too.
Boba Fett is my favorite character.
Yes, he is. He's dope.
I don't like that they changed his voice, but you know, he's trying to make everything.
Yeah, they were trying to make it, I guess,
unifiedly shitty. You know, it's that Rogue One is like my favorite. Did you see Rogue One?
Yeah, Rogue One.
But probably the best since like Empire, I thought.
Dude, thank God George Lucas is a shitty writer. Like, you realize that whole movie was created to fix a flaw in George Lucas's writing?
Completely fill in a plot hole.
So wait, let me get this straight. We built this humongous Death Star and one little and the whole thing blows? No, we gotta make a movie to fix that shit.
It's gotta be Rogue One.
Right? That movie was the shit.
It was
man.
A great movie.
You know what Rogue Two is, right?
Rogue Two. That's
you remember
the,
Rogue Two.
That's the that's the squadron that Luke.
The snow speeder.
Oh, yeah.
That finds Han Solo and Luke.
Yeah, yeah.
On the, Hoth.
On yep. Hoth. Yes.
Rogue Two. Repeat. I found them. Repeat. I've taken no acting lessons, but I found them. Horrible acting in some of these X-wing pilots.
Didn't they just like run an ad in the paper what's, back then?
What's happening, man? What's happening?
And he's like, they came from behind.
I had heard like some of the stormtroopers were like just fucking like Navy SEALs that they had gotten because they're the only guys that could like take the. Like the punishing heat from the plastic, like
yeah,
stormtrooper armor or something.
Well, you know, they wanted to go in Return of the Jedi to Chewbacca's. They wanted to go.
Yeah,
they wanted
yeah.
to go to Kashyyyk, which is where Chewie's from.
Yep. Right.
But they couldn't find enough tall people.
Yeah.
So oh.
If you look at the word Ewok, it's almost the word Wookiee. Yes. Like if you move it around.
Yeah.
Wookiee backwards.
Lop, lop.
So you got those pieces of shit. Have you guys seen the Blu-ray version of Return of the Jedi?
Yeah,
the,
I haven't. I
smoked some good shit before I watched
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I did
and
as well.
There's nothing like being high and watching an Ewok blink for the first
yeah,
time.
Yeah, dude, I
you're
watched,
like, what the hell?
You fucking leap back in your
chair. What am I smoking? What is in this shit? I just saw an Ewok blink.
Yeah.
The fuck are you giving me?
Yeah, you're like, blaze as fuck, and all of a sudden you just see this fucking thing. Whoa!
Trippy, bro.
Wow.
And then the fact they added that fucking no, like when
oh, that's so dumb.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. No. Shut where up. Is he?
Oh,
grabs?
That one. Yeah.
Buda, what shows do you do? Podcasts? You have?
I have
the one on Hamilton Radio.
Yes, I have. It's Buda Radio. So you just go to. I make it simple. You guys don't have a website, huh?
No, not yet.
Yo, come to me. I created my own. Guys, check it out. BudaTheComedian.com. That's Buda, TheComedian.com. And, you know, you go there and everything's there. Snapchat, Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, your father's ass, everything. Everything's on there, man. You guys got to come up with one for that. Because let me know. I'll help you design it and everything.
Cool, man.
Yeah,
cool,
man. I use Wix, so it's easy. And you know what's cool about it? You don't have to host videos and stuff. You just put everything like you do on YouTube or wherever you post things, and you link it to your website, and it's just cheating.
Yeah.
Because right. It lets you click on it, and it looks like it's loaded to your page anyway.
Nice.
So, yeah, Buda cool. Radio. I've been doing that a year and a half. Started out as Offenders of the Universe.
Yes.
It was Offenders Radio with Kevin Israel and Mike Ciccoli. We parted ways with that. They went on to other things, and I just hung around, and I'm like, what should I call it? Fuck it, Buda Radio.
Cool.
Why not?
Cool.
So I love it over there. You know, they're amateurs, but it's, you know, they do good by me, so
yeah.
I can't complain.
That's awesome. What was the Bald and the Beautiful? That's what you did with Craig?
Oh, yeah. Me and Craig, we had a YouTube-based video show where we went live when YouTube Live first launched. Which was horrible. I mean, it was. Like,
I had heard. I think we tried like, once.
You know what's messed up? Like, they would block us for everything. Like,
yeah.
You can't play music.
Yes.
We had a TV behind us, okay?
We couldn't play news stories.
You couldn't do anything. So what we used to do is we had a 50-inch television behind us, okay? We would show them that we're clicking on a YouTube video. Like,
wow.
And they would still block us. We're like, we're playing your videos.
Wow. Right? Yeah, it's win-win.
So it's like you know, now Facebook blocks music. It's like,
yeah.
Does Twitter block music?
I don't think Twitter has live.
Who has live? Instagram? Somebody has live.
Yeah.
Periscope. Well, Periscope is from Twitter. It's like a Twitter.
We do, what do we do? Vaughn and the
Vaughn and
Ustream, and we don't have a problem on there. But yeah, Facebook we get kicked off of.
Sometimes, like, it's been on. I don't know if we got kicked off yet, but sometimes we'll get kicked off.
I'm looking for a way to do with a show out of my home and then simulcast on Hamilton. I'm also on Demented Radio.
Yeah.
Cool. Which you guys could get, you guys could contact. Anyway, the more you guys get yourself out there,
yeah,
you guys know what you're doing. I have too much shit going on. That's the problem. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to be a comic.
Yes.
I'm running Laughter Lounge Comedy Club. I'm running two websites. You know what my problem is I would be more successful if I knew, see, like, what you're doing right here, and I would be able to do this more. You guys got the shit going on, man. Look at this stuff.
That's this dude. He got us on. Well, I got us on, but he does, too. The IPM Nation we got, that's a live.
Yeah.
That's a live radio station.
So you're in charge of, like, the orgy, man. You're like, yeah. Like, he was just fucking one chick, and he's dipping you in whole kinds of vagina.
I got.
There's I a got whole a... new pool of vagina going on.
And then we got on Podcast Radio Network, they and Vegas Radio or something like that.
Oh, okay.
Radio Vegas.
Yeah, I try to get on a different. I don't know how to get on iTunes and all that stuff. I gotta.
That goes RSS feed. Like, do you, yeah, do you upload even... your show?
We could talk after. Yeah, we're boring the fuck out of people. The TV was like, "Fuck you, I'm going." TV. Is that googly eyes on the TV?
Yes,
yes.
That is such Pee Wee Herman shit. I love it. Bop, 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 bop.
There's eyeballs on the TV!
I had just ordered a tin of googly eyes one day, and this dude just put them...
Just put them everywhere.
Everywhere.
Put them like, all over the fucking place.
Oh, my God. That'd be awesome.
We take a quick break. Take pisses.
Awesome.
Do a, watch a little Daisy Chain video, and we'll be back. All right. Be back in five. I'm eating one of these things.